Hi everyone. In this video, I will give you some introduction about multivariate statistical methods. Multivariate analysis refers to all statistical techniques that simultaneously analyze multiple measurements on individual objects under investigations. Accordingly, any analysis of more than two variables can be loosely considered multivariate analysis. Many multivariate techniques are extensions of univariate analysis and or bivariate analysis. These multivariate analysis techniques are very popular in academic research because in reality, we are dealing with multiple variables rather than just one or two variables. As we have seen in many research studies, there are cases in which we deal with one dependent variable and multiple independent variables. In some other cases, we may have multiple dependent variables with one independent variable or with multiple independent variables. Multivariate analysis techniques can be classified based on several factors. Can variables be divided into dependent variables and independent variables? If they can, how many variables are treated as dependent in a single analysis? And how are these variables measured? Typically, multivariate analysis techniques are classified into dependence techniques or interdependence techniques. A dependence technique is defined as one in which the dependent variables is predicted or explained by other variables known as independent variables. On the other hand, an interdependence technique is the one in which no single variable is defined as being independent or dependent. Let's talk about dependence technique. These techniques are determined based on the number of dependent variables and independent variables and measures of these variables. In this course, we'll only focus on some important techniques. The first one is the multiple regression analysis. If we have one dependent metric variable and multiple metric independent variables, then the multiple regressions is the most appropriate method. If the dependent variables is not metric, we should use logistic regression. Logistic regressions is a popular method to deal with binary or nominal dependent variables. In some cases, we can add non-metric independent variables in the model by using dummy variables. SPSS actually allows us to include non-metric independent variables in the logistic regression analysis. If we have a non-metric independent variable and metric dependent variables, ANOVA or MANOVA should be used. These techniques allow us to compare the values of dependent variables across different groups. In this course, I will focus more on MANOVA because ANOVA has been covered in DAV 721. Other techniques such as discriminant analysis, conjoint analysis, and canonical correlation will not be covered in this course because they are less commonly used in research, but you can read more about them in the textbook. There are some more advanced techniques such as structure equation modeling or multi-level modeling. Structure equation modeling can handle complex and structural models and will be covered in DAV 724. This is actually a popular method that has been adopted by many Embry-Riddle students. As for multi-level modeling method, this refers to statistical models of parameters that vary at more than one level. Multi-level models are particularly appropriate for research designs where data for participants are organized at more than one level. Due to the time constraint, I will not cover this technique, but if you think this is a technique that you want to learn, I can introduce several books that you can use. Now let's look at independence techniques. As mentioned before, with these techniques, we do not discriminate dependent variables from independent variables. We just consider them as variables and group them in different factors based on the commonality between variables or characteristics of respondents. We have exploratory factor analysis, which is a technique that identifies underlying factors based on interrelationships and commonalities between variables. This technique allows us to analyze the data and group variables in different factors. That is why it is also called a data reduction technique. Please note that this is a data-driven technique, which is exploratory in its nature. In some cases, we construct the factor structure from theories or literature review, and we need to use confirmatory factor analysis. Confirmatory factor analysis is a theory-driven technique. We will cover this method in DAV 724. Finally, cluster analysis is a multivariate technique which focuses on grouping objects based on characteristics they possess. It is also referred to as Q-analysis, typology constructions, classification analysis, or numerical taxonomy. In multivariate techniques, the overall process is the same. That means whenever you need to conduct an analysis based on variables and measurements, you have the model, you can determine what technique should be used and follow the analysis process for that technique. The textbook provides a very thorough explanation of each process. Let's review the overall analysis process for multivariate techniques. This process helps us make necessary decisions in each step of the process. In stage 1, we need to define the research problem, objectives, and multivariate technique to be used. Then we need to develop the analysis plan to achieve these objectives. The next step is to evaluate assumptions underlying the selected techniques. Different techniques have different assumptions. For techniques based on statistical inference, the assumptions regarding multivariate normality, linearity, independence of the error terms, and equality of variance must all be met. Before any model estimation is attempted, we must ensure that both statistical and conceptual assumptions are met. The challenge in this step is to decide what to do if assumptions are not met. Depending on the case, we'll need to study the results and make necessary decisions. For example, what to do when some variables are not normally distributed, or how to handle missing values and outliers. In the next stage, we need to estimate the model and evaluate the overall model fit. In this step, the analysis proceeds to actual estimation of the model, which will give us information to test hypotheses. After the model is estimated, the overall model fit should be evaluated to make sure it achieves acceptable levels on statistical criteria, identifies the proposed relationships, and achieves practical significance. This is an important step to make sure the data fits to our theoretical model. SPSS provides great tools to calculate the model estimation and evaluate the model fit. Again, the challenge is to decide what to do if we do not achieve the good fit. In stage 5, we need to interpret the results. Basically, we test relationships between variables. For example, what independent variables have significant effects on the dependent variable, and what is the magnitude of these effects. The objective is to identify empirical evidence of the relationship in the sampling data that can be generalized to the total population. In the last stage, we need to validate our model. Before accepting the results, we must ensure the degree of generalizability of the results. The common method is to split the sample into the test sample and holdout sample and compare the results between these samples. In other videos, I will show you some examples of actual data analysis process using SPSS or other software using example datasets. Note that those are only examples and they do not cover all cases. To fully master this process, it requires a lot of practice and experience. Once you understand the analysis process of these common multivariate methods, we can handle other methods as well. There are many factors to consider when making the decisions, and many of them are related to the ground theory, the model, and hypothesis, not just data itself. So this is the end of this video. Thank you, and bye now.